Several Philippine senators once again dismiss alleged rumors of plans to unseat Senate President Juan Miguel Zubiri. Senator Robin Padilla says he's satisfied with the current management in the upper chamber. Zubiri also earned a praise from Senator Bongbong, who describes his leadership as energetic and constructive. The Senator J.B. Ejercito, meanwhile, believes no one will attempt to wrest the Senate leadership since the position will be too big to fail. Senator Jingo Estrada, who was tagged as Zubiri's supposed replacement, also firmly denies the allegation.
I do not know where that came from. Pati nga ako nadadamay dyan. Walang ganon na usapan na magkakaroon ng kudeta dito sa Senado. The super majority, the members of the majority are fully supportive of Senate President Mig Zubiri. May mga chismis, may mga nagmamarites sa akin na ako raw ang papalit. Wala raw katotohanan yan.
Pero
pati ako nagugulat ako sa mga ganong klase chismis.
As for Zubiri, he says he serves at the pleasure of his colleagues. A similar rumor about Zubiri swirled earlier this year after the palace allegedly grew dissatisfied with the Senate's low output. Philippine President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. appoints Larry Gadon as his advisor for poverty alleviation. Malacanang says Gadon will advise the president on strategies and policies aimed at combating poverty and improving the lives of most vulnerable sectors of society. He's also tasked to work closely with government agencies, non-government groups, and other stakeholders to design anti-poverty programs. Gadon was suspended by the Supreme Court in January 2022 for verbally assaulting journalist Raisa Robles in 2021. Gadon ran unsuccessfully for senator in 2022 under the slate of Marcos.
Former Defense Department officer in charge Carlito Galvez Jr. returns as President Ferdinand Marcos Jr.'s peace advisor. Galvez, a retired Philippine Army general, held the same position during the Duterte administration. He also served in other key government positions, including the Chief of Staff of the Armed Forces of the Philippines, Vaccine Czar, and head of the National Task Force Against COVID-19. The latest development comes weeks after Marcos picked former lawmaker Gilbert Teodoro Jr. as the Secretary of the National Defense Department, which Galvez headed since January. The Philippine Justice Department seeks to move alleged drug trafficker Jad Dera out of the detention center of the National Bureau of Investigation. Dera was discovered to have been moving in and out of the NBI facility where other detainees allegedly had similar privileges. More in this report.
First, an unauthorized trip outside the detention facility of the National Bureau of Investigation for dinner. Then, previous travels as far as Tagaytay, Subic, and Calatagan in Batangas. Now, the Department of Justice is learning NBI detainee Jose Adrian Dera or Jad Dera is also supposedly enjoying several privileges like special food and sleeping conditions. The justice spokesperson putting his foot down, this is unacceptable.
We would like to curtail this and stop this practice by moving him from one detention center to another. Dahil po, sinasabi ho natin yan dati pa, no? Na yung familiarity with the detention center exposes risks. Yung mga detainees ho natin, nag-iisip po yan lagi, no? Kung paano nila, kung paano mas maging maganda yung stay nila. And that is something that we cannot allow.
The NBI filed with the DOJ last week raps against Dera and six other NBI security personnel involved. Dera is facing a complaint for allegedly bribing security personnel to allow him to get out of the NBI detention facility, with the DOJ and NBI looking into reports he allegedly paid in the hundreds of thousands to enjoy the privileges. The six NBI security personnel, meanwhile, are facing complaints for infidelity in the custody of detained persons and bribery, as well as violating the Anti-Graft and Corrupt Practices Act. The NBI also immediately removed from his post the head of the NBI Detention Center.
So at the very least, siya po ay isa sa mga tinitigan ho natin na persons of interest dito sa paglabas-pasok ni Jad Dera, pati din po sa mga privileges na binibigay ho sa kanya.
Both the DOJ and the NBI are also verifying reports that other detainees, like Marvin Miranda, the alleged co-mastermind in the killing of Negros Oriental Governor Ruel De Gamo, are enjoying similar privileges.
Medyo unique po ang posisyon ni Jadera sa loob ng detention center ng NBI dahil siya po ang mayores doon. Siya po yung pinaka, kumbaga, head no, ng mga detainees doon sa loob ng NBI detention center. Kaya siguro, yun po yung naging basehan kung bakit nakukuha niya lahat ng privileges na ito.
The DOJ vows to go after those behind this scheme, even going beyond the NBI.
We will take this investigation to the Bucor as well to make sure that none of this happens as well there. Dahil nakita ho natin yung dynamics dito sa NBI na posible ding nangyayari sa Bucor. So we have alerted already the Bucor head, Director General Katapang, to look out for any indicators or red flags that may lead to this same conclusion.
There has to be closer supervision to avoid a similar situation. The investigation is ongoing. They will let the axe fall where it may, even on the higher NBI leadership if needed, if they cannot solve this.
Dera is detained on one pending drug charge, where former Senator Laila De Lima is a co-accused. His lawyers have earlier rejected allegations he is somehow linked to suspended Representative Arnolfo Teves Jr., an alleged co-mastermind in the De Gamo slay, supposedly entrusted with paying off 25 million pesos in bribe money to the De Gamo suspects who earlier recanted their statements. The NBI reported only about 100,000 pesos was recovered from Dera upon his arrest.
The Philippine Justice Secretary takes a 10-day leave after undergoing a medical checkup last week. Jesus Crispin Remulla cited personal reasons for his wellness leave that began Monday. Remulla did not provide further details. Undersecretary Raul Vasquez is the Justice Department's officer in charge until Remulla reports back for work.
The Philippine Po body to decide on a proposal to postpone the village and youth council elections in Negros Oriental by August. This comes after 9 Negros Oriental mayors on Sunday released a manifesto expressing support for the postponement of the polls amid a culture of fear in the province following the killing of Governor Ruel De Gamo. COMELEC spokesperson John Rex Laudianco, however, notes if ever the poll body decides for postponement, the elections should be held within 30 days of October 30, the original date for the vote.
Yung kapangyarihan po kasi ng COMELEC para mag-postpone ng halalan ay pumapasok lamang sa election period. So makakaasa po kayo na pagtungtong ng election period po ay may desisyon na po ang COMELEC dito unless meron pong magaganap po ano, na pangyayari bago makatapos po yung aming hearing.
The Philippine Anti-Graft Court jumps a decades-long case in which an uncle of President Marcos Jr. was accused of amassing ill-gotten wealth. A June 23rd decision of the Sambigan Bayan 3rd Division dismissed the forfeiture case against Alfredo Romualdez, the brother of former First Lady Imelda Marcos. The court said his right to a speedy disposition of the case had been violated. It noted how state prosecutors had taken 16 years to file a supplemental petition and how their original petition was amended 3 times in a span of over 20 years. The Sandigan Bayan faulted the government with failing to fully comply with the court's resolutions. The case against Romualdez was filed in March 1996. It alleged that he and his wife, along with several other corporate defendants, illegally acquired 42 real estate properties and investments in 1986.
The Philippine Anti-Graft Court's 4th Division affirms 4 corruption charges against former National Police Chief Avelino Razon. The court found Razon had signed irregular purchase and work orders in 2007 when he was PNP procurement head. The orders covered over 409 million pesos worth of vehicle repairs and maintenance work for 28 light armored vehicles. Meanwhile, former police controllers Jerry Barrias and Eliseo de la Paz were cleared by the court due to insufficient evidence. The corruption raps stem from a 2012 ombudsman complaint against 25 police officers, 2 audit commission officials, and 13 others.
The Alliance of Concerned Teachers now preparing legal action against the Department of Education over its memo seeking information on its union members. The group calls the memo a form of profiling, an allegation rejected by the agency. Vivian Gulia reports.
Stop the attacks!
The Alliance of Concerned Teachers made this call on Monday after the Department of Education issued last June 14 a memorandum requesting its regional directors and school division superintendents to submit a complete list of teachers affiliated with ACT who were enrolled on the agency's automatic payroll deduction system. APDS is a mechanism of collecting payments through salary deduction for financial obligations of DepEd employees like loan remittances or union membership dues. ACT says several teachers were alarmed by the memo.
After po noong malawakang profiling, ay nangyari po yung maraming kaso ng intimidation at pangaharas sa mga members ng ACT since 2018. Kaya nung lumabas po ito, yun agad ang unang naramdaman ng mga teachers. Mangyayari na naman ba yun nangyari noong 2018? Magtatago na naman ba kami?
The teachers group doubts the motive for issuing the memo, saying DepEd's regional offices already have a list of teachers enrolled in APDS.
Panunupil ito, pagpapatahimik ito, union busting ito sa pinakamadaling sabi. Tahasang paglabag sa Convention No. 87 ng International Labor Organization.
ACT says it is preparing legal action over the memo, including bringing the matter before the International Labor Organization.
And the ILO can always impose the sanctions and ba po sa tariff, sa mga trade agreements. Ng pangalawa po is yung sa Data Privacy Act. So we have to discuss matters with the Data Privacy Commission. Isa is yung pagpapabasura doon sa mga data na nakuha nila out of that memo.
DepEd says such actions are well within the rights of the organization and that it is ready to respond to complaints. But the agency's spokesperson denies the memo in question will be used for profiling, noting that DepEd issued a similar request for members of other groups who avail of the APDS to consolidate the records at the central office. He explains this is to fast-track the delivery of services and responds to some complaints.
Kung may lumapit sa amin, for example, not long ago, nagko-complain, no? Regular complaints yan eh, na kinakaltasan po sila pero hindi daw na sila affiliated or dapat daw hindi sila kinakaltasan. We and the central office cannot immediately respond. Why? Because our database is not updated. We are not singling out any organization for that matter.
Vivian Gulia, ABS-CBN News.